How to Train Your Useless Dragon by Mitsuki Crispy on AO3. Summary. Bakugou Katsuki needs to kill a dragon to take its teeth and become a warrior of his tribe. But what? Why the fuck doesn't this dragon have teeth? Written from the prompt, what if Izuku was the dragon? Shamelessly, How to Train Your Dragon inspired. Chapter 1. How to Hunt Down a Dragon. Bakugou Katsuki was on a hunt, and it was not just a regular shitty hunt to bring a wild boar back for a banquet. No, today he was going to hunt down a dragon and become a warrior. Katsuki was the son of Bakugou Mitsuki, the chief of their village and the strongest Viking warrior in the whole world, as far as Katsuki is concerned. Warriors and chiefs from all over the land come to her to show their respects, and one of the reasons she was so revered was because she took down her first dragon at 17 years old. This week, Katsuki himself had turned 17. And that is why, right now, he was in this tiny, shitty boat that barely fits a man and a goat to find himself a dragon to kill. You see, dragons are fucking pests. They live in the archipelago of small islands about 6 hours sailing from Katsuki's village. And the fucking nuisance destroy every boat that come near their territory. Many ill-advised fishermen have already perished from the dragon's attack. And if it wasn't enough, sometimes the fucking lizard dare to steal sheep from their herds in the middle of the night. This is why the order for every warrior in the village was to kill any dragon on sight if possible. And it was considered an unofficial ritual of passage for every young man seeking to become warriors. No warrior would be taken serious without at least one dragon tooth hanging from a leather string in their neck. Usually, young Vikings in age to become warriors from 18 to 20 years old spend their nights awake, hoping to soar a dragon trying to eat a sheep. Or they volunteer to accompany fishermen to see if they luck out and catch a dragon away from their archipelago. But those are shitty options for shitty cowards that want to sit around their asses for way too long. Bakugou Katsuki is not a coward and doesn't have time to wait around for a dragon to gracefully fall to his sword. That is why today, when the first ray of sun peaked its horizon, Katsuki had taken a tiny boat, one that wouldn't be missed by fishermen when they started their day, dressed in his best combat clothes, rusty dark brown trousers and a light short-sleeved cotton white shirt, black boots, and a thick red cape lined with wolf fur. Carrying his best weapon, his big, branded sword, his bow and arrow quivered, and a long rope with a metal hook on the end of it. To get close to the dragon's island and hunt one down. His mother would scream like a banshee if she got wind of what he was doing. She was always nagging him about how she only killed the first dragon because it invaded her family land and was disturbing their herd. Errol, Mitsuki, ruled with an iron fist, and she believed dragons shouldn't be hunted purposefully, or else they might decide to hunt the humans back. According to his mother's rules, dragons can be killed if they come to their land or if they fly by a Viking boat. But Katsuki doesn't give a fuck about what his mother's cowardly rules. When he becomes Earl, he will hunt down every single one of those fucking overgrown lizards and get rid of those nuisance once and for all. Fuck this shit of waiting around until the dragons decide they had enough of fish and sheep, and now they want a human meat. They don't even know how many dragons there are in the fucking archipelago. But from what they've seen flying around, it was a fucking lot. Dragons of several colors, shapes, and sizes, and abilities. Katsuki would not be caught unprepared when the fuckers come, and he would show his mother how ready he is to take his place as first warrior. The position as first warrior in his village is vacant as for now. Usually the strongest warrior in the village is chosen as the first warrior, if the eel is not in condition to lead battles and raids anymore. And the fucking old hag isn't. She is old and slow, and Katsuki deserves a place of first warrior. But he can't claim to be the strongest warrior in the village without a fucking dragon tooth on his chest. And if he doesn't get it soon enough, the old hag will have to appoint someone else for the fucking position. Katsuki simply can't let that shit happen. He already can see a small island that belongs to the dragon's archipelago on the horizon. The island is so fucking small that not even his village market could fit in the shitty thing. But the good thing, he knows he will not find many dragons around here, but it would be suicide to fight more than one dragon by himself. That is alright for today. Katsuki just needs one dragon. One tooth. After he goes back to his village, claims the title of Force Warrior, and builds a hunting party, then he could come back and take down several of the flying fuckers at once. Katsuki decides he is close enough and starts setting up his bait. He brought some pieces of goat and a leather pouch full of goat's blood to grab a dragon's attention. He douses the goat pieces in blood and throws as far away as from his boat as he can. Dragons supposedly have very good sense of smell, so one of them could pick up the smell in the water if they're close enough. After setting the bait, all he could do was wait. Katsuki's sharp red eyes scanned the horizon, looking for any movement at all. The fucking lizards could fly and swim potentially, so his prey could be coming from deep under the water or from in the sky. The sun is at its peak right now, and it hurts Bakugo's eyes to look so intently. The water looks like it's sprinkled with shredded glass from how it shimmers. Katsuki's eyes are watering from the lumicity, so it took him longer than it should have to notice that one of the shadows in the water was not moving slowly like the other cloud shadows. He glares at the sea, trying to make sure it is a dragon under the waves and not some whale, but he sees nothing in it. He then looks up to see if there's anything hiding amongst the clouds and gotcha, fucker. There was something there already. It looks almost big enough to be a dragon, and it'd probably be stealthy hiding between fluffy clouds, so Bakugo can barely see the shape in its sky. But if Bakugo can't see it, the dragon probably can't see him either. The lizard's too high to kill with a sword, but Katsuki brought his bow thinking about that. However, as Bakugo is preparing his bow, the dragon drives towards the floating piece of goat. Shit. The fucking lizard is stupid. The dragon is all black and doesn't look too big from where Katsuki can see it. He didn't think any dragon would be dense enough to actually eat the goat. He thought they would be lured by the smell and notice it was bait since dragons supposedly were so damn smart. Not this dragon, though. This loser was going at it like he hadn't eaten in a whole fucking week. Well, even fucking better for Katsuki. Bakugo fixes his hook on an arrow and untatches the rope. He can't have the shitty dragon getting away from him in the sea. Katsuki pulls his bow, aiming at the beast, just as the dragon finishes eating the goat pieces, and it's prepared to fly away again, when the big lizard flaps its big black wings to impulse itself, Katsuki shoots his arrow, and it hits. The arrow itself barely scraps the dragon's thick hide, but the metal hook grabs on the scale of the back and comes ripping down until it catches the dragon's wing. The beast thrashes and pulls against the rope, but Katsuki was ready. He tied the end of the rope to his boat, and it was holding as its life depended on it. "Die, you fucking beast!" Katsuki screams, as the dragon's force makes the boat slide across the waves. Every time Bakugo pulls harder on the rope, he can feel the tension of the hook on the dragon's wing. The animal is clearly distressed, making horrible sounds. With one last pull, the metal hook slashes the rest of the wing and falls on the sea. The dragon flies pitifully, barely above the waves, completely without balance, since the left wing was so torn as he tries to get away from Katsuki. "Not so fast, you ugly monster." Bakugo takes the boat's oars and goes after the big lizard. The stupid beast is going towards the small island, where probably there isn't any other dragon help it. Katsuki has this one in the bag. Now all he has to do is get on the island, finish his kill, and grab his tooth. Katsuki rows faster than ever from the amount of excitement he is feeling. His face is contorted in a huge manic grin at the perspective of taking down his first dragon. He goes to the tiny island in no time at all, pulls his boat to the sand, no use in taking down a dragon just to be left stranded alone in a shitty island, and runs to find his prey. The island's jungle is thick, but Katsuki hears the beast wailing close by. He finds his dragon by the roots of a giant tree. It would take at least 5 grown men with their arms open wide to even hug the tree's trunk. Curled across itself and wailing in pain, it was an ugly sound and an ugly sight. The dragon was all black, but where the light that peaked from the foliage touched the scales, it shined green. It was slightly bigger than a horse, but that was still very small for a dragon. However, what made the sight so ghastly was the damage his hook did. The scratch started between the dragon's wing on its back. Then you could see the point where the hook pierced the dragon's wing and carved itself a big slash that poured red blood on the floor. There was no way the beast could fly out of here with that injury. At this point, it was probably an act of mercy to finish the kill. Hey, shitty lizard. Now it's just you and me. Don't worry, I'll make it quick. Bakugo unsheathes his sword from his hip and walks carefully towards the beast. The dragon turns its face towards Katsuki with terrified eyes. Can dragons cry? Because Bakugo swears he sees fucking tears coming out of the animal's huge green eyes. And how can eyes be so green? It's like there is every nuance of color painted in the beast's irises. Then the lizard makes more awful wailing sounds at Katsuki, its drool dripping, its pink tongue moving as he tries to talk, its teeth. Where the fuck are his teeth? What the fuck? Katsuki launches at the animal and forces its big mouth open with his bare hands. The dragon gets so confused, it stops its crying and stands still at Bakugo's explanation. What the fuck? Where the fuck are your teeth? You useless piece of shit, worthless dragon— Ugh! Bakugo takes a step back, pulling his hair in anger. He can't believe it. The first dragon he brings down doesn't have teeth. How can a dragon not have teeth? What the fuck? How can the gods hate Katsuki so fucking much? Fucking fuck! Okay, alright. Take a deep breath, Bakugo. All is not lost. You can try again another day. Except, he can't. Because once his mother finds out he took a boat and went to the dragon's archipelago, she will fucking flip out and hang him from the anchors in the middle of the village. Shit. Fuck. Double fuck. How can he fix this shit? The dragon doesn't have teeth, but its hide is not that ugly. Maybe he could skin it and make armor pieces for himself? Could the dragon's wings fit on his boat? And the shitty lizard could have claws. Alright. Shit. I can make this work. You have claws, right? Whatever, I'll just kill you and take home as many pieces as I can. Katsuki says, taking a sword from the floor where he dropped it, while checking the dragon's mouth, and raising it to strike the beast's neck and get the shit over with. Just as Katsuki goes to slice the dragon's jugular, somehow the dragon disappears, and in its place shows up a skinny boy, stark naked, crying and screaming? Don't kill Ursi! Don't kill! Deku don't want to die! Please! Please! Katsuki lowers his sword without noticing as he is completely stunned at the sight in front of him. It's a boy. But it was a dragon. But now it's a boy. The boy is skinny, looks to be around his age, has a big mop of green, dark, curly hair on the top of his head. Freckles scattered in the pale skin of his face, shoulders and chest, and big green eyes. Very green. All shades of green. Exactly like the dragon's. What the fu- Who are you? Where is my dragon? Katsuki furiously screams at the boy. This is not what he signed up for. He just wants to hunt a dragon and bring his tooth to show his mother he was ready to be the first warrior. But first, the shitty dragon doesn't have teeth, and now he has to deal with a crying naked idiot that took place of the shitty dragon? Don't kill! Don't kill! Please! Please! The kid pleads while crying big fat tears. I will not kill you if you say where the fuck my dragon is, dipshit! Me! Me! Deku! Deku! Dragon! Don't kill Deku! Deku? Useless? What kind of fucking name is that? Answer me straight, where is my dragon? Deku is dragon! I'm dragon! Don't kill me, please. What? Katsuki takes a step back, looking around to see if there's any indication that he's being pranked by some evil spirit or something of the sorts. But he finds nothing. Just a boy in a pool of blood. Actually, the blood is dripping down heavily from the boy's arm. Bakugo gets closer again and pushes the boy's body to the floor, belly down so he could take a better look on his back. And there it was. A huge wound his hook did. It started between the boy's shoulder blades and goes down the middle of his triceps. Fuck. His dragon transformed into a boy. How the fuck are you a boy? You were a fucking dragon 5 minutes ago! Katsuki screams. Confusedly at the kid. You can't kill a boy. He needs a dragon kill. He's not a shitty asshole that kills people without being attacked first. That is not the kind of warrior he's going to be. I'm still a dragon. It's just magic to be a boy and to talk. The kid says, looking at Katsuki with those big green eyes. The boy holds his wound with his other hand, and mutters quietly to himself. Talking is hard, with the tongue. Talking is hard with this tongue. Wait. Focus here. You're a dragon, right? Katsuki says, trying to make sense of the situation. Yes. Deku nods, making his curls bounce. And you have magic? Another nod. That allows you to be human. He neglates with his head. I'm a human, just appear human for a while. Whale? You mean while. You can appear to be human for a little time, but not a lot of time? Deku nods again, his confirmation. What the fuck? Why hasn't anyone told him dragons could look like humans? Does no one from his village know that? The other dragons can do that, too? The boy nods again. Yeah, but it's hard. We train magic. Be strong. That is the most incredible and crazy thing he's ever heard. Dragons have magic. They can transform into humans. And they can talk. The shittiest pronunciation Katsuki has ever heard, but they can talk nonetheless. As Katsuki is thinking about the huge implications of his discovery, the boy falls to his side with closed eyes. Shit, he's hurt. He probably passed out from too much blood loss. Fuck! He can't let the shitty dragon die before Katsuki could find out absolutely everything he can about this. Shit. Okay, what do I do now? He needs to stop the bleeding, make sure the boy doesn't get too cold, and take care of him for the night. He can do that. He is not only the strongest, but the smartest warrior in his village. He learned a lot of first aid to use in battle when he needed. So now was the time to put that shit into practice. He will not let this dragon die today. Hi. Oh my god, I'm so happy to be able to start this series. I got permission to do this series a little bit back. I really love this series. I will put a disclaimer. I have read this before, so you guys aren't like, I'm not reacting to it with you guys. If you guys get left in a cliffhanger, I already know what happens, so I'm not left in a cliffhanger. I'm sorry. I know I normally, like, I think the only other time that this has happened was with Heal Me. There is starting to be fan fictions that I have read that have given I've gotten approval to be able to podfic, so there will be some, like for example the 4 p.m. slot, so the one that comes in 2 hours ahead of time, the At Odd Ends, that one is also a fanfic that I have read before. I really enjoy How to Train Your Useless Dragon. It's a really nice, I will classify it as a crack fic very much. Even the own author, one of the tags is, if I go all the way up, it's not necessarily tagged as a crack fic, I categorize it as that, but this is getting close to crack territory is one of the tags. And no, yeah, it definitely crossed towards crack territory. Would I say this is the most beautifully written fanfiction ever? No. Do I love it and enjoy it because the author does a really good, well done thing with pacing and story building and just having this story be mainly plot driven in the point of it's... You sit here and you enjoy it. It's amazing. Yes, the author does a really good point on making the story seem interesting and entertaining. I genuinely love this. It's a crossover with How to Train Your Dragon, except this author takes the How to Train Your Dragon premise and, as you could tell, switches it up on its head. This is a BKDK fanfic, I will say that. So keep that in mind. I really enjoyed this fanfic when I first read it, and I'm happy that I got permission to be able to podfic it. It was a really good read, and there was moments where I was laughing and giggling. This is really a good, like, if you want a fanfic that just, you know, you sit and you listen to it and it makes you feel good, this is one of them. I wouldn't say it necessarily doesn't have angst. It has a little bit of, like, quote-unquote angst. I wouldn't say that it's, like, fluff-filled. I say that this is, like, happy in the sense of, like, you're listening to this and you're like, oh my god, this is funny, this is hilarious. Think of it as, like, a comedy relief, kind of. As I said, it's a crackfic. I love crackfics. I know a lot of people are like, oh, I want to stay clear from crackfics because crackfics are, like, not taken serious and they're just, like, funny haha things. Sometimes you just need a funny haha silly movie. Or, not movie, but fanfic, right? Like, for example, comedies. Technically speaking, comedies in the world of fanfiction would be considered crackfics. I'm not joking. Those would be considered crackfics. All your comedy, you know, mainly comedy movies that you enjoy so much, they would be considered crackfics in fanfiction terms. I actually once accidentally called a comedy movie. I'm like, oh, is this a crack movie? And everybody looked at me. I'm like, I meant comedy. Comedy movie. Ha ha ha. Comedy. Oh my god. Ha ha. Funny. I'm gonna go excuse myself. But yeah, this is a really cool fanfic, and I hope you guys enjoy. I really enjoy, and yeah. As always, my rain drops, make sure to eat, sleep, drink water, take your meds. Have a wonderful day or night. Link to my socials and Discord server are down in the description. Subscribe to see more of my content, and thank you so much for watching.